The age of streaming has brought many changes to the medium of television. A big example being the skip intro option. Some viewers love this option for obvious reasons. It lets you fast forward through an otherwise repetitive title sequence and get right to the show. Others hate it and argue that a title sequence is one of the most important aspects of a show and shouldn't be skipped. I'm less interested in answering the question of to skip or not to skip, and more interested in discussing what makes a TV intro good in the first place. Opening title sequences have been a major part of TV since the beginning. Many have a song or anthem that has become as iconic, if not more iconic, than the series itself. This is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. While others use the intro to explore the world of the show and set the tone for what's to come. The Walking Dead uses its simple but iconic intro to show us a grim look at the zombie apocalypse. Game of Thrones brings us on a journey through the fantasy world of Westeros. And The Sopranos puts us in the driver's seat of a New Jersey mobster going home to the suburbs. I think there's one intro that truly masters both of these elements, giving us a catchy song that perfectly sets the tone for the entire series, while also showing us the world that we are about to explore. The show I'm talking about is critically acclaimed, but criminally underrated. I'm talking about HBO's The Wire. If you walk through the garden, The Wire focuses on the Baltimore Police Department and their efforts to win the war on drugs.
Girl, you can't even call this shit a war.
Why not?
Wars end.
But despite this premise, calling The Wire a cop show would be grossly inaccurate. To me, The Wire is to the police genre what The Dark Knight is to the superhero genre. It took decade-old cliches and archetypes and reinvented them by asking, what if these were real people? I'm not going to go into the genius of the show in this video. Countless other essays and books have done that already. Instead, I'm going to focus on the intro specifically and share my thoughts on what makes it so great. Fans of the show will tell you that the most obvious thing that makes this intro special is that each season has a different version of the same song. If you walk through the garden, you better watch your back. When you walk through the garden, you gotta watch your back. When you walk through the garden, you gotta watch your back. When you walk through the garden, watch your back. When you walk through the garden, gotta watch your back. This decision perfectly reflects the structure of the show, which shows us a different side of Baltimore in each season. Respectively, the seasons focus on police surveillance, labor unions, politicians, education, and the media, all coming together to create a multifaceted depiction of a marginalized community. Each season uses a different version of the same song because each season tells a different side to the same story. The story of someone trying to challenge the status quo of their respective institution. In season one, it's D'Angelo, trying to challenge the violent traditions of organized crime.
Yeah, but the game ain't gotta be played like that, yo.
In season two, it's Frank, trying to challenge the union's treatment of its disenfranchised workers. In season three, it's Colvin, challenging the chain of command and its methods of law enforcement. In season four, it's Presbyluski, challenging a school system that cares more about testing scores than students actually learning. And lastly, in season five, it's Gus, challenging the media and stressing the importance of integrity over ratings. All of these rebels try to reform their respective institutions, only to realize the ugly truth. To the people in power, all of them are just pawns.
Pawns, man, in the game, they get capped quick. They be out the game early.
Unless they some smart-ass pawns.
The title sequence of The Wire emphasizes this never-ending cycle of pawns and kings by intentionally not showing any main characters in the intro. Instead, we are shown images of everyday life in Baltimore. Yes, there are many shows that also don't show the main characters in the opening, The Walking Dead and Game of Thrones being two big examples. But the key difference is that both of these shows have a clear group of main characters, even if we don't see them in the intro. The Wire, on the other hand, arguably has no main character. Equal time is spent between the cops and the drug dealers. And throughout the show, we see corrupt police officers and admirable criminals. There is no protagonist and antagonist, no good guy and bad guy. They're all just pieces in a larger story, and all the pieces matter.
All the pieces matter.
In a way, the city of Baltimore itself is the real main character of the show. This is why I love the title sequence to The Wire, and the reason I can never click that skip intro button. Other title sequences do a great job of setting the tone for their world. The Wire, however, grabs you by the hand and pulls you in, all in just a 90-second intro. By immersing us in the city at the start of every episode, it makes the environment feel like more than just the setting of the story. It makes Baltimore feel like a living, breathing entity. A complex ecosystem of moving parts. A community filled with hopes and dreams. At times, it's beautiful. And at times, it's heartbreaking. But no matter what, it's always honest.